I set off in May 1939 to enjoy what I thought might be the last glimpse of pre-war England. The opening sentence of a book by V.H. Morton found entirely by chance in a Kent hotel. It so intrigued Tommy Candler that she decided to retrace the author's footsteps, photographing and recording the sights he'd been so afraid would be lost forever. After all, how much could survive a Second World War? Tommy Candler set off, convinced that what hadn't been lost to war would have been destroyed by the peace. She found it remarkably the same. In fact, some things never change, they just become more so.
The interesting thing in the book is, like, the traffic is appalling at the Elephant and Castle, and it's taking your life in your hands to cross the roads at Oxford. But everything is funny. The funniest thing is the people. You ask them the way, and he could tell by the glee on their face he was lost.
Whether lost or on course, both Morton and his new disciple travelled through England on a journey of affection. Both books, in their way, are love stories, seeking and finding the one quality both authors were most afraid of losing, peace. Looking at a view like this, it's easy to forget the things that have changed. The acres of land that have been built on, the apparent takeover by the motor car, van and lorry. But these haven't really impinged on the areas Morton had picked out all those years back. They're things always at the corner of your eye, just out of sight. Are you afraid, then, that in another 50 years' time, we may actually have lost all the things that he treasured and you treasure?
Well, I think probably the things that he did in the book won't be lost, because many of them are National Trust or stately homes and monuments. But I think the things, the countryside and the general feel of England, I'm absolutely terrified will be lost. And I know that he went to live in South Africa, and he went in about the 50s, I think, and he was beginning to feel it lost then. So I'm very worried about things being lost.
Despite that anxiety for the future, it would be easy to run away with the idea that nothing had changed so far. The church in Westerham remains unscarred, but the churchyard itself bears testament to the most appalling change brought about by war. In their way, both books are a tribute to those who perished and to those who are determined to give future generations the chance to enjoy peace. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.